Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to the first of its kind in India, another first from Mystic Lotus and Dragonflies, the Mystic Lotus Violet Flame Awesome Tele Summit. Now, we at Mystic Lotus are super excited, and we know you are too. And none of this would have been possible without your unstinting support and encouragement. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. Okay, now I've been asked by a few people if they will be receiving healing for an hour. The answer is no. This Tele Summit is really for sharing and demonstrating how the chosen process can contribute to our lives. This particular Tele Summit, which will go on till end July, focuses on the very relevant and contemporary issue of stress. For example, we now know that stress causes high BP, chronic muscle pains, lowered immunity, hormonal imbalances, skin disorders, depression, the list goes on. And in fact, in America, Americans consider stress to be America's leading health problem. We don't want it to be ours. Have a listen in to how energy work can help lower your stress levels, boost your confidence, and leave you feeling optimistic and hopeful. Okay, before we finally begin, all of you are on the Tele Summit WhatsApp group. Should you have any questions, please post them on the group with your name anytime now onwards. They will be answered. There are only one or two of you who are not on the WhatsApp group. Please message your question in to me at 98300-51888. Finally, if you're not already hands-free, now would be a good time. Okay, without further ado, drum rolls please, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm Mystic Lotus welcome to the lady of the hour, Nidhu Kapoor. Hi, Nidhu.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Nilu. Thank you. I am so excited to be here. I'm so excited to be doing this. I think I know how Neil Armstrong felt when he was beginning to put his first step on the moon. Like, this is such a big thing. This is history in the making for the Indian healing industry. And while Tele Summits are not new, they are new for us. And I just want to say such a huge thank you for everybody taking time off on a Sunday evening to be here. Group hug. And I hope you have your water with you and that you're all comfortably seated.
Yes, absolutely. Super excited thank to you. Be doing this, Nidhu. And yes, big group hug to everyone. Okay, but quickly, before anything else, you've asked everybody to have drinking water handy. You've just reminded everyone again. And I've noticed that you do this very often. So why is that? I have my bottle ready. I want to know why I need to keep sipping on it.
Okay. I feel that's a good question. It's a really, really good question. And a great one to actually start off energy work. The thing is that when we begin to do proactive energy work, and by that I don't just mean healing work, but also activities like working out, like joining a gym or doing something physical, you will see that there's always a natural thirst that comes up. Because whenever there is this movement taking place physically, there's also a shift that starts taking place internally. An energy shift starts.
Okay.
This shift happens throughout the body, through each and every cell. So each and every cell starts contributing more to us, either by offloading more toxins or by receiving more nutrients. And it does this through the blood, which is 92% water. So as the water is getting used up, it needs to be constantly replenished. I must give you another understanding which is not really scientifically proven, but it is there. Not too many people know about this, but we're going to do a small exercise maybe a little later.
Okay.
To put this understanding in implementation, but our brain absorbs energy from water directly in the mouth. You see, our entire body receives everything that it receives once it goes down into the belly and is digested. The brain functions a little differently with water. It takes it straight from the mouth. And you know, whatever we are doing, we want our brain to be part of it. So please just keep that water with you. Please begin drinking it. In any case, even if you don't fully understand the science behind it, in all the energy work that I have done, that I have seen in me with others, I have seen everybody get thirsty. In fact, even before a Reiki session, and I must tell you, this is the first year I sampled a Reiki session, and the first thing the practitioner said was, I hope you've drunk your water. So I think that in most energy work, somebody will ask you to drink water either at the beginning or during or ending some point during the process, definitely.
Okay. So you mentioned Reiki. Are you going to be doing Reiki?
No, not at all. In fact, no, it's so incredible that you should say that because I was asked this just yesterday. What is the difference between the energy work and Reiki work? And the energy is actually the difference is actually something that can be sensed and understood because while Reiki would fall into the category of energy work, Reiki channels an external source of energy. In energy work, in energy psychology, we access an internal energy. So, for example, when we do an energy clearing, and we're going to be doing an energy clearing, it is experienced very differently from a dose of Reiki. And in fact, thank you so much for asking me that. If there are those here who have experienced Reiki and are now going to be experiencing this, I would love to hear back from you. I want to know if you could sense any kind of difference in either how you reacted or how you received.
Yes, that would be fantastic feedback to get. And
yeah,
a reminder, please just put it into the group, onto the WhatsApp group. Yes? Okay.
Yes.
So, Nidhu, all of this that you're doing, how do you do it? How long have you been doing this?
Okay, that's two questions, but I could tell you what I do.
Yes.
But I can't tell you how it's done. You know, it's like no two people can make the same food.
Right.
No two artists can do the same drawing. No two computer programmers will ever program in the same way. So basically, for any potential energy workers out there, and there are quite a few, and I know there will be a number of them on this call, if I do make this a step-by-step, I would be doing them a disservice. I would be robbing them of finding their own unique method of doing and understanding a clearing. So all I'm going to really say is sit back, enjoy, receive.
Yes.
You asked me something else as well? There was,
yes.
How long have you been doing this?
How long have you been doing energy work?
Professionally, I mean charging people. That would be about 4 years, but otherwise, I would say my whole life. Whenever my friends, or even strangers or animals would show up in my space being distressed, there is something I would end up doing. I mean, I don't mean in terms of being there or listening to them or offering them solutions. I mean something beyond that. There is something I activate. I think that's the best word. There is something I do as an activation. And I do that even today. Okay. I'm not able to respond to all texts promptly, for instance. So I'm not able to text out a reply. But even if I have just read it, I immediately end up activating a clearing. In fact, would you like a demonstration? And you know what the magic word is for Mystic Lotus. You know you have
hang on a second though. Hang on. This is also something you often ask, you know, say yes. Now, I know there's something to it. So the million-dollar question everyone wants an answer to is, what is it? What is this yes all about? For a second, I thought I lost you there.
No, I'm very much here. Okay. Okay, give me a few seconds to process how to explain this. There is an explanation. In fact, there is a science behind it. But since you have already said yes to a clearing demonstration, right, why don't I use the power of this energy that you have put out there and then come back and explain? Say yes.
Yes, absolutely yes. absolutely,
okay.
Yes.
Okay, so, fantastic. Please, quick question. Yes,
I think you and I leading to the same thing. Can we unmute everybody for a minute for this awesome clearing demo you're going to do with us?
You know, I can only say yes.
Yes, absolutely. Okay, so everyone is now going to get unmuted. They'll send
you are unmuted.
Off, you are unmuted. Yes. Okay. Now, I would request everyone to be silent till Nidhu says or asks for you or anyone specific. So, Nidhu, the floor is yours.
Thank you. I am not asking for anybody specific right now. I am asking group and each and every one of y'all. Are you saying yes?
Yes.
Awesome. Will you continue to say yes to the next two questions?
Yes.
Some hesitancy there. So I want to hear it one more time. Will you continue to say yes to the next two questions?
Yes.
Awesome. Yes. And question number one. Can you remove all your stress in the clearing now?
Yes.
Will you remove all your stress in the clearing now?
Yes.
Awesome. Repeat after me, please. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
For removing all my stress in the clearing.
Now.
Fantastic. Please mute back. I am going to give you 30 seconds to have a sip of water and hold it in the mouth.
You are now muted.
So Nidhu, that's a sip of water to be held in the mouth, not to be swallowed?
Not to be swallowed. So just two, three seconds only.
Okay.
The brain works faster than we can acknowledge. So just a few seconds, hold the sip of water and swallow, and I will do the same. Now, there are two kinds of clearing that I do, and I'm going to do both of them today. One of them is a verbal clearing. You're not going to hear me. You're only going to hear me introduce it. And the other one is a silent clearing, which we will see after we've done this one. Okay. In general, I just want you to pay attention to the stress that you're carrying in your body. Where is it? How strong is it? How intense is it? Nidhu, the hostess, always has to carry the energy of the group. I would like you to be answering on behalf of them right now. Go for whatever it is that is true for you. Rest assured that you will be picking up for most people on the group as well. Tell me, are you connected to your stress now?
Yeah, I'm feeling it in three places simultaneously right now.
Go ahead, tell me.
I'm feeling it a little bit in my tummy, but not lower down, slightly higher up. And okay. A little bit, matching it behind in the back. And a little bit in the head. And I've actually never, normally when this kind of question comes up, I know there's always one place that I know it's there. This is the first time it's popping up in two, three other places also.
That good connection. You see what your brain has done with just that sip of water being held in the mouth? It's already working better. It's giving you answers so rapidly. It's taking your attention and awareness to where it needs to go. Fantastic. I am going to now ask you to please give me a intensity rating, also known as an SUD, on how much is the stress in your tummy right now on a scale of 0 to 10, where 0 is not at all and 10 is very high.
4.5.
And the middle back, behind the belly?
4.95 to 5. I'd say 4.95 to 5.2.
Okay, I'm gonna take the higher rating.
One.
We always take the higher rating. That's right. Tell me, how much is it in the head?
7.
Then I'm going to begin with the head. Also, would you like to make this a little more specific for me? Is it the sides of the head, top of the head, the forehead,
general top,
head?
General top, more towards
general
the, like the middle of the head, onwards, forward, not back.
And
the top
I
of the head.
Can, all right. Connecting to you. Connecting through you to the group now. Giving you another 30 seconds. Please do repeat the exercise with water. Hold it for a second in the mouth. Swallow it. Opening portals, opening gateways, activating clearing now. And a very swift gush came in. Did you feel it? If your eyes are closed, Nidhu, don't open them.
Yeah, there was a sudden acceleration of the heartbeat for like a second.
Like the gush. Good.
And the I know you said you're focusing on the head. It has moved a little towards the for lack of any other word, as if it's gone outwards. So it feels as if it's shifted to the side. Now, I'm not sure whether to express that as a moving out or an actual movement to the side heading outward.
And on a scale of 0 to 10, where you were at a 7, how much is it now at the side?
At the side, 6. And then
check your...
There's been some kind of shift.
Fantastic. Good receiving. Check your stomach right now, where it was at a 4.5. How much is it?
In fact, I was going to tell you that. Thank you for asking. The tummy is pretty much said it's okay. You don't need to focus on me anymore right now.
Fantastic. Can we say 0?
Yes. I'd actually, okay, no. Yeah, my first instinct is to say 0, but if I have to be completely honest, I'm going to put it at a 0.5. Put it at a 0.5.
Please be only completely honest. Yes to honesty.
Yes.
Okay, and your middle back was at a 4.95. Will you please check for the group?
One. But it's still there. But it's on its way out.
4.5 is how much?
4.5, I said one. I said it's still there, but it's on its way out, but it's still there. I can still feel a nag somewhere. So one.
All right, and one it is. All right, I am shifting and reactivating, clearing, beginning again from the head. Opening portal, opening gateway, activating, clearing, now. Much gentler receiving this time, didn't come in as a gush. But please feel free to have some water. And we will check again. And when you have water this time too, please hold it in the mouth. And then swallow it. And I will do the same.
Well, thank you for the reminder to hold in the mouth and swallow, because I took a sip because I was feeling thirsty and like promptly swallowed it. And then the moment you said that, I quickly took another sip, held it in my mouth. And then, you know, like I got caught with my hand in the cookie jar. Quickly take a sip before you figure it out.
And you notice how your first question is being answered by you. As something is shifting, there's a thirst that's coming up.
Right.
So you need the hydration. But yes. Go ahead. Please check your head. The size where we began in the middle at a 7.
Yeah.
At a 7.
At a 7. In the middle.
Yes, at a 7. Yes. And move to the side at a 6. How much is it now and where is it?
Moved, still off from the center, gone to the sides. I would very confidently be able to rate it at a 2 right now.
Awesome. Yes to miracles.
Yes to miracles.
Yes to miracles for everybody.
For everybody.
All right. I'm going to put that down at a 2. Is there somebody that you would like to take feedback from? Is there anybody responding? I cannot be on the group, but would you be able to check and tell me? Is there somebody who would like to say something?
Yes. Yes, of course. I'm going to call out the last 5 digits of your mobile. You'll get unmuted, and you can therefore then give Nidhu your feedback as in how she asks you. Okay, the
give
last
one
five,
person at a time.
Yeah, this is the last 5 digits belong are 12032.
And yes. As you said this, Nilu, I must just tell you that I felt something else move out further from your body. So please check your head now.
Ah, okay. Just went on to this completely focusing backwards, as in back onto the head. Yes. Yes, definite movement out.
And from a 2, where are we now?
0.5.
Almost gone. Fantastic. Fantastic. And this will be true for a lot of people on the group as well. I mean, that's the power of working in a group. It's the power of doing something when we are together. In the Bible, it says, where 2 or more of you are gathered, there I am. When a group gets together with a single point, focused agenda, magic happens for everybody. And I'm so sorry. This is also to give you all a little bit of time to let the clearing settle in further. I can see that it's going in deeper. And now, please tell me, who is the one that I'm going to be speaking to right now?
Yes, I'm calling out another 5 digits right now. The last 5 digits are 01776. That's 01776.
Hi, that's Nidhu. Hi, Nidhu. Hi.
Hi.
The stomach stress really eased out very well. I'm burping. And Nidhu, I'm sure you're going to be happy that I'm burping.
Yes, and thank you so much for bringing that up because I did not remember to tell everybody some of the signs of the shifting, not just hers, but also burping, yawning, slight heavy-headedness, wanting to sleep. Please go to sleep, but don't disconnect the phone.
Okay. The pain in the head shifted to my right arm.
Okay. How is the rest of the body? Would you like me to go, would you like me to activate a clearing for that part of you now? Is there any other part that you would? All right. If you will just please have the magical sip of water where your brain also starts healing and following instructions better. So please have that sip of water and so will I.
Yes.
Hold and swallow. On a scale of 0 to 10, where 0 is not at all and 10 is intensely high, how much is this pain?
In the arm, 4.
Okay. Opening portal, opening gateway, activating, clearing now. Rapid shift is taking place. Are you getting thirsty, like really thirsty? Is your upper lip or throat becoming very dry?
Yes.
Please have that magic sip of water. In fact, and after you've had the magic sip of water, have some more water that you can just drink straight away.
Better. And more books.
Getting fantastic. But somebody else, because I'm fully connected to you, but I can, somebody else on the call is also getting extremely thirsty, but they're not realizing it. Somebody is not drinking water. There's a dehydration that's, somebody is not drinking their water. Can you please do this immediately? I sense masculine, so it could be, it could be a man, could be, please drink water. Thank you. And Gitu, please tell me, how much is the pain in the arm?
Nearly gone.
Awesome. Yes, the miracles. Yes. Fantastic. You had also mentioned your head. Tell me how that is.
The head is also a little heavy now. I think the pain shifted into the arm and moved somewhere. But there's something in the nape of the neck, which is still there.
Right side?
Yes.
All right. You know, heavy-headedness is part of the energy shift. As long as it's not become pain, that will move out on its own. I'm going to be shifting the flow to the nape of your neck, and so please have your sip of water while I'm doing this. Opening portal, opening it, activating clearing for right side nape neck now. Is something also happening in your stomach?
Yes.
Are you getting a little nervous?
Yes.
Why are you getting nervous? Do you know why you're getting nervous?
Yes, it's a concern about my health, you know, that was making me nervous since morning, you know.
Okay.
I was going to call you after this call.
And you are so blessed. The universe hears you. And just check the nape of your neck before I shift a little bit to your stomach. Is it also the fear of change?
Yes.
Would you not be who you are if you were absolutely all right and in good health?
Yes. There's this whole drain of energy that's happening since the last 2-3 days. And I have no idea from where this comes. And that's making me nervous, it's scaring me, and I don't know what's happening. It's some, I don't know what's happening. Let's just say that.
I appreciate your honesty. Check the nape of the neck.
Easy.
Good.
But still there.
On a scale of 0 to 10, how much is it? In the easing, how much is it?
3, 2, between 2 and 3.
And check your belly.
It also, there are a lot of burps, a huge burps. Now it's around 3 and 4.
Good. Check the nape of your neck again.
1 and 2, between 1 and 2.
Good. Good. Here's something that I am getting, something that we could take a look at for sure. Yeah. I just want you to acknowledge this. You can do this when you've gotten off the unmuted button with me right now. And the sentence is, I'm afraid of the new. And all you're going to do is just acknowledge this. So when I say acknowledge, you're not going to do any specific processing around it. You're just going to sit down and say, I'm just so afraid of the new. And at the end of the call, I want you to tell me how you are. I can see that you are easing up. I'm going to do one more very, very minor clearing. The group may not feel this so much. I'm going to do it very, very specifically only for the belly for you right now.
Mm.
And done.
More burps.
Good. Excellent.
Thank you.
Excellent. I was telling a few people yesterday as well that when I first started my energy medicine, my energy work, energy psychology group, that anytime all these, you know, need to go to the washroom, yawning, burping took place, everybody had to applaud for me.
Okay, let's applaud.
Yes, to applause. Thank you, Nidhu,
for being here, and thank you for being so open with this.
Thank you. Thank you for doing this on a Sunday evening. Big hug.
Thank you, Nidhu. Anything for you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, my love. Thank you.
Thank you.
Nidhu, we have time for one or two more.
Please, yes, absolutely. Yeah, I want to do at least 5 people.
Oh, great, fantastic. So we're taking on mobile number ending 40440. That's 40440. Just give it a few seconds, you'll be unmuted right now.
Okay. Do you have a name?
Think this is there you are, Ashok.
Yeah.
Oh, hi. Hi.
Hi, Nidhi.
Hi, Ashok, how are you? What may I do for you?
Actually, when Nidhu started, I could identify with myself with all the places she mentioned, all the 3 places.
Right.
The pain is gone, but I'm having difficulty in breathing. Like, you know, as if my nose is blocked. Like my breathing is becoming.
Did you say as if my nose is blocked?
Actually, it is not even nose blocked, but my breathing has become very heavy.
I got it. Where is the breath getting stuck? Is it in the throat, upper chest, lower belly?
No. Actually, along with it, you know, I have symptoms of, you know, very strong burning in the chest region. But I feel the breath is getting blocked. It's somewhere in the upper ridge of the nose.
Upper ridge of the nose,
that's where I have to put pressure.
I'm just going to shift to the burning and ask you about that, but I've already done a little clearing for the ridge of the nose. Please take a breath and check again.
Uh, uh, now I can identify it much better because it is getting blocked in the right side of the ridge of the nose. Maybe, you know, the right side is more blocked. Earlier I couldn't pinpoint. Now I can pinpoint better.
Good. That's because both sides were blocked, but obviously one has opened up. So this is a little easier.
There were, yes, you are right. Actually, one has opened up. The right side is still blocked. You are right there.
Thank you. I am going to leave that there. I'm going to, because the clearing is already done for that part. So I'm going to give it a few more seconds. Tell me about the burning.
Burning is not there, but still the sensation is there in the upper part of the face.
Sensation?
Is
the sensation not, that of burning? Is it like become
burning
hot instead of
sensation
burning?
Sensation is not. No, it's not become more. It is actually gone, but some feeling is there. Not burning, but some, you can say something is still stuck there.
Something is still stuck there. Okay, I'm just going to do a far more generic one. Group connecting to all of us right now, because all of us, given that we live in very, very polluted environments, we're constantly exposed to noise, we're constantly exposed to pollution, we're constantly exposed to chemicals in the air, radiation as well. I'm going to do a general one for everybody around the upper chest and lung area. So please let us take a magic sip of water. Please take the sip of water, hold it in the mouth. You may find that as you're holding the sip of water, that you feel like holding it a little longer. Please feel free to do that. Our energies are living, sentient, vibratory intelligences. It's guiding you somewhere right now. Opening portals, opening gateways for lung and chest. Activating clearing now. Ashok, there's something you are not letting go of. Everybody, because I've activated this for everybody, there's something you're not letting go of. There's something stuck because you're refusing to exhale. I instantly saw the exhale become better, which means that something did step out of the body, but there's something you're holding on to. In the understanding of how energies work, you have the power to hold on to something, even if it's not really working for you. So what I want you to do right now is say yes.
Yes.
Ashok, I want you to represent the group. Yeah. Yes.
Yes.
I'm willing to let this go now.
I'm willing to let it go now.
Yes, I am ready to let this go now.
Yes, I'm ready to let it go now.
And very nicely done. Something has gone. Everybody, just please take a normal breath and see how much better you are already breathing. Your chest is already a little better. Your bellies are already a little better. Please check. Nilu, I want you to check as well. Just, Ashok, please check and tell me.
Left side is absolutely clear. Right side, some blockage still remains, but I'm feeling pain in my right hand little finger since maybe past 1 minute or so from the time we started clearing. Like, you know, the nose started clearing up, the burning went away, but it moved on to my little finger. And pain is posterior.
Tell me, is it a throbbing pain, a flowing pain, or a single stationary one place pain?
It is stationary.
Then hang on. Would you please gently stroke the little finger, like you're stroking something out of the little finger?
Yes.
Our energies respond to that as well, by the way. anybody, if you have pain somewhere in your body and it's a body part you can reach easily, just gently start stroking that part of the body in an outward motion. Like you're taking something from that body part and putting it out. Like putting it out. Like how you would take something and throw it out of the window. Like that. Just put it out. And check now, Ashok.
It is still there actually. It is now moved. It is less, but I think it's gone actually, yes. It's gone.
Okay. Yeah. But thank you so much, because almost everybody has brought up the sentence. Not everybody. It's still there. You know, it's still there carries two energies. It's still there. It's not gone. It's not changed. It carries the energy of attachment to that pain. And along with that, it carries the energy of refusal to acknowledge the good that is taking place. You know, sometimes we've lived with pain for so long that in letting it go, there is this huge discomfort in even acknowledging that it's going. Because something good is happening, something right is happening, and that's hard for us because pain always makes us feel a little bad, small, wrong, unwell. So when we say it's still there, check how you're saying it. Because you're not hearing the attachment in the sentence, I am. The desire that nahi nahi dard to thoda bahut kahin to hona chahiye, nahi kyun hona chahiye, bilkul nahi hona chahiye. Pain is very closely related to stress. Stress will cause pain. Nilu, you said chronic muscle tension, and chronic muscle tension is lower back pain, upper back pain, head pain, cramps in the belly, knee area issues because the ligaments can get very stiff and tight. What you want to always do and be prepared for in an energy clearing is know, number one, something will shift. This is a guarantee. Therefore, you must allow for you to be completely open to the awareness of where the shift is taking place. Nobody comes to EM unless a part of them is really sick and tired of where they are ready to let it go. You are ready to let it go, so don't hold on to it. Please take the magic sip of water again. Ashok, did you take magic sip of water enough time?
Yes, yes.
Awesome. One more time, please, for the group.
Yes, done.
Awesome. I thank you so much. I thank you so much for representing the group. I thank you so much for being here.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone.
Big hug.
Thank you.
Ashok, please, once you've gotten muted, please hold the water in the mouth a little longer and then swallow.
Oh, thank you. Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. Before we unmute the next person, just a quick question. If you throw up while this is happening, is that a good thing or... Is it you know, stuff that's needing to get out of you, so it's getting out?
It is. It's, of course, it's a good thing in terms of an energy diagnosis.
Okay.
But it's obviously a terrible thing because, you know, throwing up is just, you know, it just makes us feel miserable. You know, it makes our throat miserable. It makes our belly miserable. But it is a good thing. It is a great thing. If somebody's throwing up, I want to know immediately so that I can just activate not a clearing but a download for them. Is somebody throwing up?
Yes, I'm going to unmute them right now. The next is ending 7651. That's 17651.
Do you know the name?
It's Kadambari.
Kadambari, all right.
Hello?
Kadambari?
Hi. Hi, Nidhu.
Hi. Hi. Are you throwing up? Is that, are you the one?
Yes. I threw up a lot.
I'm so sorry.
No, actually, I kind of feel better after throwing up. Which is
I'm not sorry that you've thrown up, but I'm very sorry you had to throw up. So, you know. Yeah. I'm glad you're feeling better. Good. Good.
Yeah, I'm feeling very light.
Good.
Very, very light. And I'm feeling good, which is very weird. So...
you've just received a fantastic dose of very, very brand new, spanking, clean, pure, white, bright, light, new energy. So it's wonderful that you're feeling that way. Is there something that I can still do for you right now?
No, I'm happy. I'm in part of this.
Yes to happiness.
Yes to happiness.
Yes to more happiness.
Yes, absolutely. Yes to more happiness. All of
even
us.
If it requires throwing up, so be it. Yes. Throw up and be happy. Yes to happiness.
Yes to happiness.
Awesome. Awesome. So nice to hear from you, Kadambri. Thank you so much for joining. Big hug to you.
A big hug to you as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nidhu, because we're coming to the end of the hour, I do wish for people to return to their Sunday evening, and we will take another few minutes anyway. There was a question you had asked me that I said that I would answer. Before that, is there somebody that you have mentioned that will be on the call? And is there anybody...
Well, as you've said, it is a Sunday evening. Maybe I could just take you through a couple of the reactions everyone's had, and you could just let us
please,
know
yes.
what's going on with that. So about him, Ashok, with his feeling breathless, there has been a reaction of the hand feeling like it's freezing, a heavy head, a burning in the chest, yawning away to glory. With a very happy smiley face with hearts on it, which I'm very happy to see, and the back hurting and a ball in the tummy and the shoulder hurting.
Do you have the names for all these people?
Yes. So we have the shoulder.
One moment. Let me just quickly activate, and I'm going to say activated, and you're just going to read out the name, only the name.
All right.
Activated.
Zenith.
Just pick the name.
Yeah. Zenith, Rohini, Padmasoni, Karishma, Nagpal, Sabina Thakur, and Tejal. That's it.
Awesome. Everybody. And everybody else as well, please, magic sip of water. You know, I so much want to do all of them. I want to do it for all of them. But you know what? So I have a suggestion here.
Yes, please.
We will complete. Somewhere at the back of my mind, I know that there's a question I still have to answer. I'll have to be reminded about that question.
Hey, don't worry.
I wish to do this. Yes, if they are comfortable and they don't have to be elsewhere, and if they would like to stay, what we will do is finish our call, disconnect, and I will. And just please come back for them. Would that be okay with you, Nidhu? Do you have the time?
Yes, absolutely. Everyone's names I've taken, and one or two more are, I think, typing in. I've already started getting yeses.
Fantastic! Everybody knows the magic word.
magic word.
Yes.
Yes.
Awesome. So I'm gonna take them on. Yes, absolutely. After this is done. Could you please remind me, what is the question you had asked?
The question was the million-dollar question. What is it with the yes? What is that
in voice? Yeah. Correct, I remember. Okay. I had wanted to spend some time on the three laws of energy. I think that I've used up most of my time, but let me just mention it for what it's worth. The three laws of energy. Sorry?
It is worth a lot. Please do.
Thank you, Nidhu. The three laws of energy govern our lives. They govern the law of attraction. They govern the law of manifestation. These are the three laws of energy. Law number one, which you have read and heard and seen and maybe understood, maybe not. Law number one, energy goes where your thoughts, feelings, and behavior go. In other words, energy goes where your attention goes. Law number two, energy expands cosmically where it is sent. In other words, energy expands in ways that you cannot measure when it goes where you have sent it. Law three, it's a yes universe. In other words, wherever you have sent your energy, because it would have cosmically expanded over there, which you cannot measure, the universe will find a way to make sure that you get it. Now, while this also forms some of the basis of the book, The Secret, there is a deeper understanding to these three laws. Not everything we think about or make the intention for comes true. And while that's the conversation I did want to have around energy work and energy psychology, perhaps we will return another time. Perhaps we will close season one with some amount of energy work again. I want to explain the YES protocol. The YES protocol, which is a series of the two questions followed by the thank you. I wish I knew who I could give credit to. Because the YES protocol, when it showed up, I usually make a note. Because if it's not mine, or if I have not discovered it, or if I'm using somebody else's explanation for my own understanding, I want to give that credit, if not the cash. So, but I do not know who the YES protocol belongs to. I knew its power because it activates the first law. Remember, energy goes where your thoughts, feelings, and behavior go. In other words, energy goes where your attention goes. In the moment that you have said yes, your energy has instantly gone into receiving mode.
Fantastic.
Unlike, say, the power of no. No is a wall.
Right.
Whatever you say no to, there's a rigidity to that wall. But the moment you have said yes, your attention will take the energy in wherever it is that you're going to. So yes to happiness, yes. Yes to miracles, yes.
Yes.
Yes to, what else did we say yes to? Yes to being de-stressed. Yes to being at peace. And you know, one of the things that we did in our energy medicine workshop, which was like stupendous, and I don't know if Vinod is on the call, but thank you so much, Vinod. And what he said was, yes to unexpected bonus. And yes to unexpected bonuses, and yes to unexpected bonus. It was astounding. Each one of us who were part of that, workshop had unexpected bonuses that week. It was marvelous. It was awesome, like our Tele summit.
Wow.
So yes to unexpected bonuses. Nidhu, say yes on behalf of everybody, and everybody say this loudly, say this yes to unexpected bonus.
Yes to unexpected
bonus. Fantastic.
Thank you. Awesome.
Fantastic.
Thank you for that very simple explanation. I think there's a lot that's been opened up to think about. As we've already said, we are kind of running out of time, but I'm sure this is on everyone's mind. How can we be a part of this, of what you do? How can I, for example, from a different city, be a part of it?
Good. Nice. Thanks for asking me about being from another city as well.
what I've done for the next 3 months is put together a package. I've put together a package of energy and medicine workshops as well as telecalls. I've put together clearings like the one we've done today, and I still want to do the silent one as soon as we finish this conversation. So I'm going to rush through this before the 1.5 hour cutoff point cuts off most people.
Right.
I have put together 3 one-on-ones. A one-on-one is a one-on-one with me, either in person or on the phone.
That's
so if
three
you
of them.
See every 3 of them, because everything is for the next 3 months.
Okay.
The thing is, everybody needs to know this. Healing or beginning healing or manifesting or attracting is not a one-day job. It's not a one-workshop job. It's not a three-day workshop.
Right.
You have to stick with it for a while. You have to
Absolutely.
Show up and be committed to the yes for whatever it is that you are seeking in your life. And so normally, three of my workshops would cost anywhere from about 18,000 to 21,000. Now, sorry, not three, six, because I do almost 2 a month. So over 3 months, that's 6 of them. A tele clearing with me, and this I do anyway, is about 8,500 for 5 to 6 calls. My one-on-one range from 15,000 to about 24,000, although there are those that I have been working with for a while who I do charge a little lesser from.
Right.
If you look at the entire package, it's between 40 to 50,000 for 3 months.
Right.
And I would like everybody to say yes to begin your practice, begin your journey. I would be delighted. I would be so happy if you began this with me. You do not have to pay this kind of money. The offer for those who are in Bombay and can attend the workshop, instead of anywhere between 40 to 60, the amount is 10,000.
Oh my goodness.
It's about 10,000.
I had to react. That's like almost 75%.
Yes.
Wow.
And 75% off.
75% off. For, that's 10,000
right.
for 3 months?
Yes, that's right. Inclusive of everything.
Inclusive of... Good God, woman, how more super awesome does this get? Seriously, how does
Thank
it get
you.
Any better?
Thank you. Nilu, are you signing up?
I'm saying yes.
Yes.
Why didn't I ask? What do people from outside the city do? You said people in Bombay, but I'm going to make sure you do this for me as well. 3 months.
Awesome.
How does this get any better? What else is possible? What more can we receive?
And you've given us some fantastic, fantastic positive power statements from Access Consciousness. But thank
yes.
you anyway. How does this get any better? Yes, yes, yes.
And may I
yes.
say, so I'm going to use this now. All of us at Mystic Lotus are going to use this now. What you've done right now, basically, you've given a godfather of an offer. Now, for anybody who's a hardcore movie buff, you know Godfather is the movie. And Nidhu, I know you've also seen it. So
yeah.
Would you like to tell people what one means by saying Godfather offer? Because for me, it's a movie reference, so I know what it means. But I've used the word, I'd like for you, since it's your offer, you're the first one to do this, please tell everyone what a Godfather offer is.
A Godfather offer is an offer you can't refuse. So don't.
Great. Fantastic. Absolutely.
Nidhu, how will they sign up?
Yes, that's what I was getting to. You can make an online transfer. The details for payment will be posted on the TeleSummit WhatsApp group and will be mailed out to everybody who has sent me their email IDs. If there's anybody on this call right now, which I doubt very much, who's still not sent me an email, just send me one at Nilu, that's NWLU, at themysticlotus.com. you'll get the payment information on the group as well as via mail. And it's very simple. It's an online transfer. We can guide you through that process as well. And of course, Nidhu, if depending on if somebody is locally there or not, if more payment options open up, we will let everybody know on the group.
I understand, in fact, that more payment options, at least within the next week or 2 weeks, will be opening up, right?
Yes, they will be. So we will. Awesome. There, people will remain updated on the Tele Summit group. So at least for the next few days, please don't exit. You'll get all the information here.
In any case, there would be details of the other people coming on, like next Sunday, the next four Sundays.
Yes, yes. This group will remain at the end of July, and everything will be posted here regularly, apart from the other normal modes of communication we use, which are our emails and our campaigns and our WhatsApp groups and our FB page.
Awesome. Yes. Awesome. Awesome. I must thank you, Nilu. This is wonderful. I'm just so proud that we've started, that we've put out India's first Tele Summit for the healing industry. And if you, along with everybody else, will join me, please, in the silent clearing. In the silent clearing, you're not going to hear me give you any instructions at all. What I need you to do is take the magic sip of water.
All right.
Take the magic sip of water again. And take the magic sip of water again. Your silent clearing is in place. You will only be able to receive as much as you can handle. In fact, within the clearing, you're going to have a desire to either move away from the phone or disconnect the phone. Either way, close down the call. For the few people who are meeting me again, we shall do so within 20 minutes. Nilu, I will leave that to you, but don't answer anything now. I've already activated the silent clearing. So whenever you're ready and you know that you finished receiving, I thank you again for your presence. I hear your thank you too. Feel free to disconnect and cancel.